kayo or ano, unmute nyo na lang kung nakikita nyo. Okay, so for the ingredients, dagdagan ko yung ano ha, natapon yung ating oil. So we have 2 tablespoons of oil, 1 half onion. So i-slice natin to guys muna. And then we have curry powder. We have this green rice. Okay. And then chicken chopped into pieces. So i-chop ko pa lang to guys. And then we have big tomatoes. Ayan, sobrang big niya talaga. Nakakatuwa. I love tomatoes talaga. This is one of my favorite and this is good for you guys. Ayan, good for us. And then 3 cups of water. So I have here water. And then, small potatoes. Sabi small potatoes, pero ang laki din ng potatoes natin. So, sabi ko nga sa inyo guys, you don't need to peel it, but you have to wash it thoroughly to remove yung soil at saka yung mga dumi-dumi niya. Okay? And then, yung boiled eggs, it's optional. I won't be using any egg for this recipe. And then, we have coconut milk. We have 1 1/2 cup of coconut milk. So, just to, and then I have here some chilies and green onions, pang garnish natin. Siyempre, we want our dish na maging colorful kasi alam natin na it has to have a texture, color, taste. So, yun yung mga elements na dapat na ina-achieve natin when we cook. Okay, so I'll just set this aside for later. So, ayan. So, I'll be cutting up the onions first. Okay. So, dalagan natin siya. Nililipat din mo pala. Pumatay na. Trash bowl. Guys, I would suggest you guys, pag nagluluto kayo, you have to prepare a trash bowl beside you para yung mga kalatsyala isi-shoot nyo na lang dyan immediately, hindi yung nagkalat kung saan-saan yung mga pinagbalatan. Okay? So, I'll just cut this up guys ha. Nagaling muna natin yung balat guys. So, very, very quick to prepare. Saute and then konting ano lang next natin kung tomato. Ang galing lang natin yung part na may pinag-anohan ng stem. I think we will only be using half of this. So just like so. Sabi ko nga sa inyo, hindi na natin yung potatoes. And then guys, dito sa recipe na to, nakalagay, kasama siya na inaano, kasama siya ng chicken na i-boil or i-simmer. But for this particular recipe, I would like to, i-fry na muna siya ahead. Kasi that's how I cook. Para hindi siya yung parang nalulusa, something. Kapag binuto mo na siya. So, ayan. So, ipa-fry na lang muna natin ang tomatoes. Like so. Maglalagay tayo ng manika for this. kini-check ko kasi if you can clearly see yung ating ano. Guys, if you have any question ha, just let me know para at least habang nagluluto tayo. Ang potatoes natin, it takes a little while to cook kaya medyo siguro ito eh, 5 to 8 minutes to cook both sides. At least yung parang fry-fry siya ng konti. Okay? So, tanongin na muna natin yung mga dito. So we have here water and the curry. This so the potatoes is almost ready. So I'm ready to add up. We will just add a little more of the oil. Oil for this. We will add the onions now. Nag-a-adjust lang ako guys dun sa temperature ng ating induction cooker ha. So, yan. Medyo as you can see. Check yung chat guys, baka may mga nag-chat, may mga question, may ito na dito. Ano po mahina po internet ko. Okay, internet naman. Okay, so we are 7th year in the meeting room. Okay, so ayan. Then let's add the chicken now, guys. Para sa bench. You also don't want to overcook the chicken kasi mawawala yung moistness sa loob. So, at this point, guys, I can already add the curry powder for this. And then, add a little bit of sugar, like so, and then i-ano na natin siya, halu-haluin natin siya. And then we will add yung ating coconut milk, okay? So guys, it really smells so good and I hope na tablespoon is okay. And then we will add a little of water. And then we will allow this to simmer until it's totally cooked. Okay? Siguro it will take around another 10 to 12 minutes. Look at that, guys. The color, sobrang ganda ng kulay niya because of the tomatoes, the combination of the tomatoes, and then the color of the curry, it really blended so well, so perfect. Ayan. So, let's allow this to simmer for a few minutes, and then this is done. Guys can see that is the chicken curry. So this is boiling perfectly. We are ready to plate this. So we still have this potatoes here. Almost done, guys. Okay. So, in a little while, ilalagay na natin yung potatoes niya. Okay? Hintayin lang natin siyang mag-boil a little more. Okay, so, that's perfect. Look at that. It's boiling perfectly. So, we can add up our potatoes now, like so. And look at that, guys. Look at that. There you go, guys. Look at that. So we are ready to plate this. So this is done, guys. So I am going to plate this on top of the white rice. Okay? Lagyan lang natin sa sakit niya. ginising nyo, you want it really hot or just a medium heat. So this is how it looks like, guys. So we're done with our first recipe, Malaysian chicken curry. Guys, do you have any questions? Guys, are you ready for the next recipe? You have the ingredients here already. Guys, very quick to cook. So, unahin natin yung oil. Then we'll add the butter. Guys, now when you cook, dapat malinis at maayos and organized. Danger zone na tinatawag, temperature danger zone. So, bumaba na yung kanyang, tumaas na yung kanyang temperature kasi tinow mo na siya. Tapos, hindi mo naman siya tinuloy na iluto. Binalik mo ulit sa ref. Ibig sabihin, nag-invite na ito ng maraming bacteria. Tapos, ibabalik mo siya sa freezer and then, ilalabas mo ulit after ilang araw. That practice is yung hindi pwede. Okay? That would affect the texture. Yes? Alin-alin? Actually, depende kung hanggang hanggang gaanong tagal mo siya tinow eh. Ngayon, kung natow mo siya until na-reach na yung talagang sobrang lambot na at hanggang nag-discolor na siya and then nag-change na siya ng amoy, that is really another thing. Hindi lang serious food safety na pinag-uusapan dito. Plus, the quality and the texture of the meat. So it's important guys na when you put out a frozen meat from your refrigerator and then you thawed it, kailangan iluto niyo na siya. Okay? So yun. So at this point guys, yung ating beef, mislice ko siya ng maninipis, strips, beef strips actually. This is tender already. So sabi ko nga, huwag na natin siyang patagalin. Then we can add everything up, like the soy sauce, and then the oyster sauce. For this particular recipe, I'll be using 2 tablespoons. And then, the sherry wine to give it flavor. Okay, and then yung sesame oil. Okay? So if you can see this, guys, this looks good already and it smells good already. And then finally, we will add yung ating calamansi juice. For this one, I use 4 calamansi for this recipe. So, yeah. I think I want to add some more oyster sauce on this. Just to enhance the flavor even more. So, yeah. Once this is all incorporated, vegetables. Magkasabay. Pwede na magkasabay ang carrots at yung
stay and I'm will grow.